So yes, we have one more speaker in this first part before the break, and that will be Daria Malyarenko, who's going to talk about diffusion phantoms for ADC mapping across different MR vendors.
Good morning. Thank you for introduction and invitation to present. At least it is good morning in Michigan. This talk will overview research primarily for improving reproducibility of apparent diffusion coefficient and may go a little beyond ADC if time permits. I have a couple of disclosures for licensed IP relevant to this talk, and also should warn of likely bias by location for the described research and resources mostly to North America. To concur with previous speakers, I would like to emphasize that reproducibility is not just a good research practice, but a key prerequisite for clinical translation. Our Phantom research was inspired by involvement with multi-site clinical oncology trials that evaluated ADC to aid biopsy-free diagnostic management and therapy response prediction. To establish accurate diagnostic threshold, these trials sought ADC reference standards, also known as Phantoms, for bias evaluation and protocol standardization. KIBA RSNA now in ADC profile includes recommendations for Phantom use as an integral part of clinical trial workflow, including platform qualification, periodic QA, and performance evaluation. Based on our experiences, we contributed a chapter to a quantitative imaging network book recently published by AAP, devoted to role of Phantoms for characterization and reduction of technical variability in quantitative imaging biomarkers. Compared to familiar technical variations from scanning and analysis workflow on individual platforms, for multi-site trials, there is an added dimension of cross-site variations. Test-retest studies are indispensable to characterize repeatability, precision, which would otherwise be overestimated by the Phantoms. Physical Phantoms cover a broad reproducibility landscape with particular strengths in characterizing hardware-induced variability, while DROs are best used for image analysis and parametric model evaluation. Next slides will show a couple application examples for ADC Phantoms. Several physical ADC Phantoms were implemented and in use to date for system QA preclinical and clinical studies. For system quality assurance, in research environment, ice water provides a viable option for temperature control, good SNR, and accurate ground truth value in the tissue relevant range of 1.1 micron squared per millisecond. But it is limited usually to 1D sampling, one-dimensional sampling, because usually placed in tube. Gel-based Phantoms that prevent bulk fluid storing provide large real estate and allow testing uniformity with respect to isocenter, but have lower SNR due to T2 damping and absolute diffusivity dependent on scanner room temperature. For preclinical scanners, the same materials can be utilized to provide accurate ground truth ADC, and the challenge shifts to testing resolution and partial volume representative of minute animal body habitus, for instance, like 2 millimeters versus 0.5 millimeter for mouse T-bear shown here. For Phantom use in clinical environment, the time saving and easy prep become important, and the range of ADC values is desired with preferred scanning at ambient temperature. This necessitates temperature monitoring and calibration for specific Phantom materials. Furthermore, permanent Phantom housing has to feed specific imaging coils, like for shown here, NIST polyvinyl pyrrolidone Phantom for head and breast coils. This increases overall Phantom cost. Low-cost ice water Phantom can be manufactured on site and used for highly accurate calibration of diffusion gradient and other diffusion Phantoms. As shown here, a couple percent difference between diffusion gradient channels can be detected with the Phantom and corrected to a fraction percent accuracy. Same phantom can be used to characterize much larger spatial ADC variations due to gradient nonlinearity, for instance, as shown for three systems in this plot. This is measured as deviation from the true ADC marked as horizontal line. GNL bias can range between negative 50% along magnet board to positive 40% vertically and horizontally for the same system and cause cross-system variability of average of 20%. By accounting for this bias, the cross-system reproducibility can be improved down to 5% error measurement noise represented by the widths of the curves in this plot. The gel flood phantom that provide 2D mapping are useful for QC of emerging vendor implementation of bias correction on clinical systems, which can be a black box otherwise. This can help to compare to gradient models and improve B-value uniformity for individual systems, as well as reduce cross-system variability, similar to the previous example. Our site co-clinical myelofibrosis trial also uses ice water phantom for ADCQC for the mouse tibia imaging. Previous study reported fairly large, up to 15% bias across seven animal scanners. Our test showed that the problem may be likely corrected on the newer systems, achieving better than 3% accuracy for mouse tibia ADC. This phantom is also now used by co-clinical imaging research network-wide round-robin harmonization project. Our West Coast collaborators have used ice water phantoms for system qualification and protocol QC in imaging arms of the breast cancer clinical trials. Retrospective application of gradient linearity correction for phantoms in these trials appropriately restored true ice water ADC values across gradient platforms used in the trials, making this narrower histogram out of the two humped before correction. When applied to patient images, the correction shifted down the diagnostic threshold derived from the mean lesion ADCs, which otherwise would depend on the relative gradient system characteristic weighted by number of the patient scan, as shown on the left. The ice water component of the NIST PVP phantom is also used for conformance testing by KIBA DWI profile. System performance metric is evaluated for bias, B-value dependence, short-term repeatability, and signal-to-noise. System linearity is also measured over the order of magnitude ADC range provided by the phantom components, as shown here for the example QC report. The signal-to-noise measurement performed using multi-scan procedure described in this reference provide good approximation of system noise by measuring it from temporal variability of the DWI signal as a function of B-value. The uncertainty of this estimate improves for increasing number of scans. The measured SNR plots compared to two fields show reasonable results, higher SNR at 3T versus 1.5T, and also higher at the, as you can notice, at the first non-zero B value, which has a three-directional averaging for trace versus single acquisition for B0. Noise evaluation from phantom DICOM images helps inform the noise model for ADC DRO development, which allow prediction of noise flow bias dependent on B-value used for ADC fit. DRO is generated by forward modeling of mono-exponential diffusion using the range of ADC values and SNR and multiple B-values. It is not anthropomorphic, but should be helpful for the software QC and analysis. The phantom measurements can be also used to corroborate ADC DRO performance by matching phantom and DRO SNR used from four-scan procedure recommended by KIBA. The corresponding ADC uncertainties are also matched. Negligible noise flow bias was confirmed for the phantom measurements, all happening in the range above Kramerau bound visible on DRO. Notably, both noise estimates and uncertainty become unreliable below this bound by the multi-scan procedure. This DRO can be used to optimize intended B protocol toward minimizing uncertainty and bias for the target ADC range. In collaboration with Sloan Kettering Cancer Center, who is running head and neck cancer study, we have recently developed a multi-exponential diffusion phantom, which allowed optimization of analysis protocol for MALDI-B acquisition to constrain maximum B values in the feed that avoids pseudocurtosis observed, example, for the negative control mono-exponential sample, and model divergence for media with restricted diffusion. It also permits evaluation of B-range dependent bias in ADC feed slope for different segments of true multi-exponential signal. Similar to ADC DRO, the forward modeling was used to develop DROs for a set of non-Gaussian diffusion models utilized in clinical trials with input parametric maps shown on this plot, and B-value set used by Medical College of Wisconsin prostate cancer diffusion studies. This noiseless DRO were used in a recent QAN project to establish multi-feed concordance across the sites that were processing the MCW dataset. Even in the absence of noise, the finite feed bias less than 0.5% shown in the left column maps here was detected in the range of, for instance, IVM fraction greater than 50%. Example, it is negative for the IVM fraction itself versus positive for the diffusion coefficient. The overall feed algorithm concordance across sites also allowed, also showed small standard deviation overall, but these errors would be amplified in the presence of noise. We note that the developed diffusion imaging DROs use preset set of B values and input ranges. So sharing the actual DRO engines, as was shown by previous speakers, would allow higher flexibility. The acquired patient images may also serve as DROs. Example for acquisition protocol optimization, shown here, for instance, a reduction of the number of B values required for the same fidelity of the feed. Also for development of tissue mimicking phantoms, as shown here by the blue dots. Here we used the data shared by Medical College of Wisconsin to design materials that imitate restricted diffusion in aggressive and indolent prostate cancer. The developed phantom can be used for evaluation of different biophysical models and their biases and acquisition protocol optimization. In summary, we find that physical and digital phantoms play complementary roles for improving ADC reproducibility. Physical phantoms help hardware and acquisition protocol evaluation and measure realistic noise, while DROs facilitate testing image analysis pipeline and biophysical model bias. The challenges are in that physical phantoms provide unrealistically good SNR and more costly to manufacture with specific form factors to fit different coils and biophysical characteristics, while DROs require noise model and use static input parameters, however, allow virtually infinite model complexity. The desired improvements are in representing combined system parameters and biophysical models in a single physical phantoms. This is where the field is moving now, and providing DRO engines. Would like to conclude with acknowledgement of our academic collaborators who propel the efforts to bridge technical solutions and clinical applications. We are also thankful for NIH finding that supports this research, and thank our collaborators from KIBA and NIST who develop metrology standards for diffusion, and our industrial partners providing commercial grade image reference objects and improving scanner capabilities for better reproducibility. Together, we can hopefully hit the promising target for clinical translation of accurate and reproducible diffusion imaging biomarkers. Thank you for your attention.
Great. Thank you very much, Daria. That's an excellent talk. I'll just give people a second in case they would like to post any questions in the chat or the Q&A. If not, I just wanted to comment on how large the effect was for the gradient on linearities in your diffusion phantom, and you know, the fact that some of this is kind of hidden behind the scanner calibrations that are done by engineers, etc. I wonder how easy it is to access some of these things that are going on behind the scenes on scanners in terms of filtering and correction factors, and whether those can be incorporated by different sites to improve their phantom measurements as well.
We definitely have you know, the tools, the vendor agnostic tools that could be applied for the gradient nonlinearity corrections. However, as you pointed out, the difficulty is in getting the good model descriptors of the systems. And we have a benefit of participating in academic industrial partnerships. So the vendors share this information with us, and this is how we actually were correcting the data for clinical trials. So they shared information for 10 gradient systems that were participating in the clinical trials. So they are willing to help, definitely. But the challenge there actually is to come between the vendor conventions, normalization conventions, and linking to the DICOM. This is the output is DICOM versus, you know, the conventions are usually in a magnet system for each system. So it's much easier, I think, for the users when the vendors implement these corrections on the scanners. And actually, a couple of vendors already are moving in this direction. So there are tools that are available on scanners. But there you would want, of course, to do some QC procedures. And this is where I think the phantoms are helpful. So you basically can run the uniform phantom with large field of view and check that the performance is reasonable for the correction. So that's, yeah, this is what we are kind of finding helpful in our research.
Brilliant. Thank you for Thanks very much.